We covered in Yama, Ahimsa, Satya and Asteya, we covered in the previous classes. And Brahmacharya, it opens up in many dimensions, and literal meaning is Brahmacharya is celibacy. As a deeper meaning, this it says even an unmarried man can be not be a celibate, or married man can be a brahmachari. It gives an example that in the scriptures, and Arjuna had three wives and three main wives, and Ashwatthama was a bachelor, and Dronacharya's son. And after the war, Ashwatthama discharged Brahmastra to destroy the Pandavas. But Arjuna countered that one with another Brahmastra. That great, it's Vedavyasa came. He said, please withdraw the Brahmastra. This otherwise it will bring a havoc to the universe, havoc to the world. And they could not, nobody withdrew that one. And Vedavyasa says, true Brahmachari, he can withdraw the Brahmastra. Arjuna could withdraw the arrow, whereas Ashwatthama could not do that one. Though he was a celibate, he could not withdraw that one. Literal meaning is not just not marrying. It doesn't mean that you are a Brahmachari. It's a Brahmachari that, it's a deeper meaning, that meaning of Brahmachari. Brahmacharya is thinking something higher, have a vision. Think something big, think something noble, that is called as Brahmacharya. Other day, Richard Branson, it's a founder of Virgin Airlines, he was talking about that one, that when I read about these great business people and philosophers, at some point they talk about the same thing, maybe it's talking from different dimensions. Richard Branson was saying that everyone should think something high and noble, that it is not easily attainable. Everyone should have a project in personal commitment in their life, some big project. It is not easily attainable, and work throughout their life to attain that one. It is Richard Branson's definition. And the same scripture also says, everyone should have a goal, and it's a target. Without any target, we are passing our lives. Dikha jayega, whatever happens, we'll see. Why worry now? That no plan, this we may plan for the company, we may in the core committee of the planning strategy, or we are in the strategy group, but when it comes to our personal goal, there is no commitment, there is no goal in our life. That have a commitment, have a target. That is my target, and throughout my life, I don't lose the sight of my target, I work towards that one. That if you have that commitment and start working towards that one, you will be surprised how things come into place. It's like a jigsaw puzzle, slowly, one by one, start marrying each other and you are working towards that one. It's Brahmacharya. Brahmacharya means have a goal, have a noble aspiration. It is not a destructive aspiration, have a noble aspiration and work towards that one. That is called as Brahmacharya. Brahmacharya, and what is the benefit of having a Brahmacharya, having a goal? Patanjali says, those who are established in Brahmacharya, it's a glow, lot of radiance. They are very dynamic person. Their dynamism in their increases, radiance in their personality increases. Brahmacharya and Aparigraha. Aparigraha means minimize your personal needs. When it comes to serving the community, accumulate more and more resources for serving the community. When it comes to your personal needs, minimize your needs. Minimize to the barest minimum. J.R.D. Tata, it's a founder of Tata group of companies, Tata group in India has, they are into almost in all fields, starting from manufacture of salt to to steal cars, everything. That it's a well branded company. And Jayaraday Tata, when he went to a public place, that in a swimming pool, one person was taking the after bath, that one big block of soap that he used and he threw it. Maybe it's worth five rupees. And Jayaraday Tata, that company owner, he said, why are you throwing that one? It has a value. He said, you should be happy. I'm using your soap and I will buy another one. He said, not that one. It's every cent counts. Don't waste. That it's precious. Not that, don't show off that you have money. It's every cent counts, and many people don't have that one. Have concern for others. This minimize your needs. That keep using that one. Even if it is a small piece of soap, still its worth is there. Try to utilize that one. And it's Jayaraday Tata's inspiration to the common man. These great people, whether in the business area or in philosophy, they talk about the same theme, that think alike. Aparigraha means minimize your personal needs. Don't keep on hoarding that now Christmas time, 80% sale, 90% sale. It's after Christmas Day, Boxing Day, it's a 90% sale. Whether we buy that one for next year Christmas, we'll keep that one. That they say that minimize your needs. The hoarding cost in the company, if I'm working, that stock turnover is there. They work on stock turnover in a year. How many times this stock is turning over? If it is only one time, they said not to keep any stock. If the high turnover is there, then only you keep. If you buy for next Christmas, stock turnover per year is only one. Or it may be forgotten also. That not to keep hoarding. If you start hoarding, it will attract rats and thieves and many other things, and you have to worry about paying extra insurance premium. That they say if you are not established in Aparigraha, do not minimize your personal needs, there won't be any Brahmacharya. That without having a Brahmacharya, that there won't be any Asteya. That you start stealing from others, start taking, corruption increases. That in India, corruption is rampant because there is no Brahmacharya. That keep everyone's property. I think that is my property. I want more. I want more. And without Asteya, that there won't be any truth. Without truth, there is no Ahimsa. Ahimsa is the Paramodharma. To have Ahimsa, we need Satya, Asteya, Brahmacharya and Aparigraha. These are the five Yamas we covered this time. And we have been chanting Bhagavad Gita. As I mentioned, next week is the it's on Ekadashi day. That Sunday is Ekadashi, and Monday also is Ekadashi. It's Gita Jayanti falls on Monday 24th. Most of us have holidays on it's Monday. That Gita, Bhagavad Gita, is called as a foundation of yoga. It's all chapters of Bhagavad Gita talks about yoga, different dimensions of yoga. As a practitioners of yoga, we are indebted to Bhagavad Gita on next Monday. That in case, whatever reason, if you can't do it on next Monday, do it on Sunday. And read as much as possible. That we covered last week, second chapter, 18 shlokas we covered. Last time we covered 15 chapter. And I will just introduce you to Bhakti Yoga today. And in the past we covered different parts of Bhagavad Gita. We'll chant the Sita Prajna Lakshana. It talks about, Arjuna asked that one, the person who has mastered yoga, that how he sits, how he walks, how he sleeps, how he talks. What is the nature of the person who has become calm and serene? That's the aim of yoga also. Have a balanced personality, Sita Prajna Lakshana. That's the Arjuna asked that one. In next 18 shlokas, Krishna elaborates that one. That what is the Sita Prajna Lakshana? Arjuna uvacha, Sthita prajnyasya ka bhasha, samadhistasya keshava, sthitadikim prabhasheta, kimasita vrajeta kim, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. Prajahati Yada Kaman. Sarvan Partha Manogatan. Atman Yeva Atmana Tushtaha. Sthita Prajnasya Dochyate. Dukkeshu Anadignamanaha. Sukesho Vigata Sprahaha. Vitaraga Bhaya Krodha. Sthita Dirmuni Ruchyate. Yas Sarvatra Anabhisnehaha. Tatta prapya shubha shubham. Nabhinandati nadveshti. Tasya prajna pratishtita. Yada samharate chayam. Kurmongani vasarvashaha. Indriyani indriyartebhyaha. Tasya prajna pratishtita. Vishaya vinivartante. Niraharasya dehinaha. Rasavarjyam rasopyasya. Param drishtva nivartate. Yatato hyapi kaunteya. Purushasya vipaschitaha. Indriyani pramathini. Haranti prasabham manaha. Tani sarvani sayamya. Yukta asita matparaha. Vashehi yasyendriyani. Tasya prajna pratishtita. Dhyayato vishayan pumsaha. Sangasteshu pajayate. Sangha sanjayate kamaha. Kamat krodho vijayate. Krodat bhavati sanmoha. Sanmoha smriti vibramaha. Smriti bramshat buddhinasho. Buddhinashat pranashyati. Ragadveshu vivyuktaistu. Vishayanindriyaischaran. Atma vashyer videyatma. Prasadam adigacchati. Prasade sarvadukhanam. Hanirasyupajayate. Prasanna chetasohyashu. Buddhi paryavatishtate. Nasti buddhi ayuktasya. Nacha yuktasya bhavana. Nacha bhavayata shanti. Ashantasya kutasukam. Indriyanam hi charatam. Yanmanonur vidiyate. Tadasya harati prajna. Vayur nama vivambasi. Tasmadasya mahabaho. Nigrihitani sarvashaha. Indriyani indriyartebhyaha. Tasya prajna pratishtita. Yanisha sarvabhutani. Tasyam jagrati sanyami. Yasyam jagrati bhutani. Sanisha pashyato munehe. Apuryamanam achala pratishtam. Samudramapa pravishanti yadvat. Tadvat kamayam pravishanti sarve. Sashanti mapnoti nakama kami. Vihaya kamanya yasarvan pumam. Vihaya kaman sarvan. Pumam Sharatinis Prahaha. Nirmamo Nirahankaraha. Sashanti Adigachati. Yesha Brahmi Siti Partha. Nainam Prapya Vimuhyati. Stitvasya Antakalepi. Brahma Nirvanam Richati. Om Tat Sat Iti Srimad Bhagavad Gita Su. Brahma Vidyayam Yoga Shastre. Shri Krishna Arjuna Samvade. Sankhya Yoga Nama Dvitiyodhyayaha. The 15th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. Urdhva Moolam Adashakam. Ashvattam Prahuravyayam. Chandansi Yasya Parnani. Yastam Vedasa Vedavite. Adaschordvam Prasita. Tasya Shakaha. Guna Pravrdha Vishaya Pravalaha. Adascha Moolani Anusantatani. Karmanubandini Manushya Loke. Narupamasyeha Tato Palabhyate. Nanto Nachadir Nachasam Pratishta. Ashvattamenam Suviruda Moolam. Asanga Shastrena Dridena Chitva. Tatapadam tatparimargitavyam. Yasmin gatana nivartanti bhuyaha. Tameva chadyam purusham prapadye. Yata pravarti prasita purani. Nirmana moha jitasanga dosha. Adhyatma nitya vinivritta kamaha. Dvandvairu muktaha sukadukka sanyehi. Gachyantya mooda padamavya yantat. Natadbhasayate suryo. Nashashanko na pavakaha. Yadgatva nani nivartante. Taddhama paramam mama. Mamaivamsho jiva loke. Jiva bhuta sanatanaha. Manashashtani indriyani. Prakatistani karshati. Shariram yadu vapnoti. Iccha pyuktramati ishvaraha. Grihitvaitani sanyati. Vayur gandhani vashayat. Shrotram chakshusparshanancha. Rasanam grahanamevacha. Adishtaya manaschayam. Vishayan upasevate. Utkramantam sitam vapi. Bhunjanavvagunanvitam. Vimudananu pashyanti. Pashyanti jnana chakshushaha. Yatanto yoginas chainam. Pashyanti atmanya vastitam. Yatanto pyakrita atmano. Nainam pashyanti chetasaha. Yadaditya gatan tejo. Jagat bhasayate kilam. Echandramasi echagno. Tattejo vidya mamakam. Mamakam. Gama vishyacha bhutani. Darayamyaha mojasa. Pushnami chaushadi sarvaha. Somo bhutvarasatmakaha. Aham vaishvanaro bhutva. Prani nam deham ashritaha. Pranapana samayuktaha. Pachamannam chaturvidam. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishto. Matta smriti jnanam apohanancha. Vedescha sarva hameva vedyo.
Vedescha sarva hameva vedyo.
Vedanta krit veda videva chaham.
Vedanta krit veda videva chaham.
Dvavimo purusho loke.
Dvavimo purusho loke.
Ksharascha ksharayeva cha. Ksharas sarvani bhutani.
Sarvas sarvani bhutani.
Kutastho akshara uchyate.
Kutastho akshara
uchyate. Uttama purushastvanyaha.
Uttama purushastvanyaha.
Paramatmeti dahritaha. Yolokatriya avishya. Vibartavya ishvara. Yasma aksharmati toham. Asmada aksharadapi chotama. Atosmi loke vedecha. Pratita purushottamaha. Yomameva sammudaha. Janati purushottamam. Sasarva vidbhajatimam. Sarva bhavena bharata. Iti guhyatamam shastram. Idam muktvam mayanaga. Etat buddhva buddhimam syat. Krita kritascha bharata. Iti shrimad bhagavad gita su upanishatsu. Brahma vidyayam yoga shastre. Shri Krishna Arjuna samvade. Purushottama nama yogo nama panchadasho adhyayah. The 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, it's Arjuna asked the question. It's whether to worship Akshara. It's Akshara means Lakshmi, Lakshmi Tattva. So many people that Navaratri time that worship feminine part or masculine, that Purusha. So whether to worship Akshara Tattva, Lakshmi Tattva or Purusha Tattva, which one is better? And it's Shri Krishna says worshipping the Supreme whether through Lakshmi or directly Purusha. And Shri Krishna says both are good. Worshipping through Lakshmi is more difficult. It's a feminine, when you are doing the mantra upasana, it's a Durga Stuti and Lalita Sahasranama, worshipping the Supreme through that one. If you do some mistake while pronouncing expression, there is a bad impercussion. Whereas, it's, you got to be extremely careful, otherwise there will be a negative effect. Whereas if you do the sadhana on the Purusha, even if you, there is a mistake, it is, there is no bad effect on that one. It's a stri upasana that it's very difficult and the chances of fall is higher than, much higher. And Purusha upasana that worshipping the Lord directly, it's the safest means. That is the gist of it's a 12th chapter and it talks about who is the devotee, what are the qualities of devotee, it explains in detail. I will start off with first two shlokas. Arjuna vacha.
Arjuna vacha.
Evam satata yuktaye.
Evam satata yuktaye.
Bhaktastvam pariyupasate.
Bhaktastvam pariyupasate.
Echapyaksharam avyaktam. Desham ke yoga vittamaha. Shri Bhagavan vacha. Maya vesya mano yemam. Nitya yukta upasate. Shraddaya pareyo peta. Teme yukta.
Teme yukta.
Te yukta. Yukta tama mataha. Yukta uttama mataha. That it's that person is the greatest one. That both are good, but worshipping me, that is the best one. We will repeat that one again. Maya vesha mano yemam.
Maya vesha mano yemam.
Nitya yukta upasate.
Nitya yukta upasate.
Shraddaya pareyo peta.
Shraddaya pareyo peta.
Teme yukta tama mataha.
Teme yukta tama.
And you can read the rest the next week. Lay down on your back.